Hello, hello, yes, yeah, my name's Carwyn, a beautiful Welsh name for a beautiful Welsh pair of legs. And I'm from Carmarthen, which is the oldest town in Wales. Oh, yeah, it's brilliant, we just had the grand opening of our blockbuster video. Nah, people are quick to turn their noses up at Wales' oldest town, but I was there for Christmas, and let me tell you, the pick and mix that you can get at Woolworths now. Absolutely sublime. Now, I'm actually from a really small village outside of the town, deep in the countryside. I'm from a village which is so secluded that all it takes to be seen as a man of the world is if you drink lilt. As a child, you'd go over to your mate's house, and if they had a bottle of lilt on the counter, you'd be like, wowee, you guys been on holiday recently? Gracias, Mrs. Thomas. Yes, I'll take a glass, but let me put on some sun cream first. Lots of people learnt new skills during the lockdowns, but it's easy to spot the ones that went too far learning something new. I saw a van in Carmarthen a few weeks back for Bob's Plumbing and Audio Editing. I mean, calm down, Bob. There's a jobs crisis at the moment, and the reason's probably because Bob's taking all of the work. I tried looking up to see if I could find Bob on Trustpilot, because I could imagine that all of the reviews would just be something like, well, Bob was only meant to replace the U-bend under the sink, but ended up offering to DJ at my brother's wedding, and tried to sell me a CD of his experimental new electro tunes. 2 stars for the plumbing, 5 stars for track 17. It was actually a bit of a banger. I bet Bob gets such a kick when he has a client phone up that needs 2 of his services, you know? Both of them. Like when somebody phones up like, hi, is this Bob's Plumbing and Audio Editing? Oh, thank God, I've just had a burst pipe in my son's music studio. There's no chance he'll get his playlist ready for the school prom now. Fire up the Bobmobile. Nah, so I grew up in the countryside and I loved it. And I love it when nicknames stick, not because they make much sense, but just because they're fun to say. Like, there was a girl in my year, her dad was a vicar, and her mum worked in a gym. And to this day, we still call her Jehovah's Fitness. Yeah, Bob's like the human equivalent of those shower gels that they make for men who suffer with toxic masculinity. You know the ones I'm on about, right? Yeah. 5-in-1 shower gel. For the man that just wants 1 casserole that does the lot. Body, shampoo, conditioner, toothpaste, and can unblock a sink. I play rugby, right? Because I am a massive stereotype. And one of my teammates had a bottle of 9-in-1 shower gel. I mean, this stuff was so full of testosterone, I sniffed the bottle and it made my nan pregnant. One of the butchest things about it was, it didn't even say on the bottle what those 9 things were. All I know is after he'd finished using it in the shower, the groundskeeper borrowed it to top up the oil in his lawnmower. One of the few things on the bottle that you could make out was just the phrase 100%. 100% what? I have no idea. That 100% could have referred to anything like 100% likely to kill anyone under 9 stone. There's a 100% chance you will grow a set of abs on your forehead. Made from 100% pure pork scratching. Now, last month wasn't all that good for me. And have you ever had a really shit month? And you get to the end of it and you think, ah, thank God that's behind me. But then your phone, without prompting, decides to make you a montage of photos from your horrendous month. Now you're given 2 minutes of photos, caked in anxiety, all set to the happiest, bounciest music you've ever heard in your life. It gently fades from the photo of that bike lock that used to be attached to your bike, into the screenshot of your positive COVID test, and then fades beautifully into a photo of that ultrasound confirming that your nan is indeed pregnant with a shower gel. I grew up in the countryside, and I grew up in the 90s, and back then, everything was so dangerous. I mean, who here remembers the game British Bulldogs? I mean, it's incredible that many of us survived. For anyone who isn't familiar with British Bulldogs, I reckon the way to sum it up is, you heard of World War I. Well, that was safer than a round of British Bulldogs. especially in the deep countryside, in a school where even the geekiest girl in your year drinks raw unpasteurized milk. And hit 6'2" while there were still stabilizers on her bike. Believe me, when she hit you in British Bulldogs, she hit you hard. It kind of gave you the feeling that she didn't like being called Jehovah's Fitness. I know, you've been great. Thanks very much, Nostar.